What's going on, my Broodwar brothers? Welcome back to another replay cast from the ladder. We've got TAENGU here in the top right hand corner, his opponent SOULKEY in the bottom right. And I know I've been doing a lot of SOULKEY games recently, but you know what, I just don't give it, I don't give a crap, man. Who cares? This guy is amazing. I'm super hype about watching him soon in the ASL. Really looking forward to those games. And yeah, he's just been putting out some amazing gameplay recently. And of course, I'm trying to learn Zerg. I'm trying to improve. We've been grinding away on the ladder here and there, getting close to that A rank. We're like 1800 pretty consistently now. But it's tough. It is tough. This is one of those matchups that I'm still not totally comfortable with. I'm still not confident in. Zerg versus Terran is incredibly hard. The overall win rates for Zerg are depressingly low. And for good reason. There's a lot of things that Terran players can do in the early game, in the mid game, right up until Defilers are out, really. There is a ton of stuff that Terran can do. And then once Defilers are out, it's still not over. It's not like you just win when Defilers come out. It's still a hard game. Defilers are very hard to control. You spend so much time trying to make your way through the early game, through the mid game, to try and get those Defilers out and be in a good position. And then you don't get a lot of chances to practice using Defilers in those situations because you don't make it there most of the time. And then when you do make it there, your control is just a little bit off and you make a small mistake that ends up ruining your game. It's just a big old mess. I know you can feel my frustration, but it is what it is, guys. We're going to be watching SOULKEY here, checking out this build, what he's going to do, and hopefully gaining some insight into how this man is performing in this matchup. How we can copy some of that as well. Maybe we can pick up a few things. Let's just see here. We've got a 12 hatch with that pool and gas right on afterwards. Pretty standard build here. Probably will line up for potentially a 3 hatchery or a 2.5 hatchery play, as we like to say. A couple lings are coming out. Looks like we got 2 pairs on the way. That's pretty standard right now from what I've seen with the amount of marine pressure that these Terran players are putting on these days. Pretty much a necessity, I would say, to get this set of 4 lings. Now, he's going to try and hide 2 lings up here on the high ground. Okay, he does bring them down now. Thought he might be hiding them up there to potentially, you know, wait for the Marines to come all the way across the map and then see if he couldn't get a kill on those Marines. But instead, he's just going to focus on taking out this SCV, and with the 4 lings out, the Marines have to go home. I've started doing this as well, just always making 4 lings. It's not worth it, I feel, to skimp on 1 pair of lings to just build, or just to build 1 pair of lings to skimp that 50 minerals to get 1 extra drone out. I just don't think it's worth it anymore. Terran players are too aggressive with their early Marines. They're too good at, you know, catching you off guard and just getting the you know, the drone kills. Even lost mining time at the natural is so painful. You can just add it into your build. Okay, I'm gonna build 4 lings and that's that. I don't need to think about it. I don't need to play this early game with checking with the scouting and making sure, seeing how many are walking across the map. No, we just make 4. We're gonna be fine. If he tries to fight us with 4 Marines, we'll probably get a few kills. Can always follow that up with a few more lings. And look at this, he's gonna go for the 3rd base down the bottom left. Now on this map, I feel like this base is really hard to control. This matchup on this map is so tough, guys. It really is. I find it incredibly difficult, and looks like we're gonna have to throw down a couple sunken colonies here. Unless, he can delay this just a little bit more. If he delays it a little more, he could actually cancel. He does cancel. So that's pretty good to hear by SOULKEY. Keeping the lings in the back, you can see. Right as the 2... Oh, he gets a Marine as well. TAENGU. His first season in the ASL. This is a really, really recent game, guys, by the way. Just in the last couple of days. TAENGU, who managed to make it into the ASL, he's not quite on the Soulkey level, and I'm assuming we're going to see a Soulkey victory here in this game. I think pretty much everybody's going to be imagining that it should be a Soulkey victory, but this is the home stage of TAENGU. This is where he thrives here on ladder. He might not be the greatest Terran player at the events, right? At a LAN, but he is very, very good on the ladder. He's got some really, really good solid plays, some solid builds. I don't know if he can handle the Muta Micro of Soulkey, though, because we've got, what's this, 6 Mutas, 4 Mutas coming across. The other two showing up here in a moment. That'll be 6, and the 7th is right there. What's he going to follow this up with? Looks like he's going to go after a couple of Marine kills to start things off, see what he can pick up. Third Extractor is on the way here. Going to get into that 3 gas pretty soon. Does lose 1 Muta already. A little bit annoying here, but he's picked off quite a lot of Marines, man. That's some serious damage right now. I believe this was the +1 build from TAENGU. Transition into the 4 racks play. It's very popular right now. Very hard to hold on against. You really need kind of stellar Mutalisk control to be able to just battle this big Marine army that's going to be coming out here really, really quickly for TAENGU with that +1. It does fight very, very well, so you have to be quite cautious here with your Mutalisk and also aggressive in order to, you know, pick off as many Marines as you can, not lose Mutas like that. You can see he just lost 1 Muta kind of for free there. You do not want to allow that to happen. You got to keep picking away at this Marine Medic group, and eventually overwhelming it on the map would be the ultimate goal. Soulkey here, kind of dancing around this little ramp area. That ramp is a great location to fight. Fighting over here is really, really good as well. That's why we've got the 2 turrets. He would like to open up that position, though. If he can get in there, pick off those turrets, and open up that spot, he could end up taking over this little position here and forcing the Marines to run up this ramp while hitting them from an angle is a really good way to get a lot of value out of these Mutas. Now, he is going into a Hydra's Den, and with the Hydras coming out here, he should be able to start to morph Lurkers and defend his bases. However, the Marine Medic group is starting to grow pretty darn large. Great trading here on the side of these Mutas. Really great trading, picking off a ton of these Marines. Now that +1 is done, able to trade much, much better here, and we will be going into Hive. Lurker upgrade is on the way. Diving in here, Ling's gonna be pulled back. Mutas are getting relatively low here. TAENGU, pretty good defense thus far, but not able to get out on the map at all. Soulkey oppressive with his Mutalisk here, keeping TAENGU back. And this is something that I need to learn how to do, guys. Keeping back a Terran player on 4 racks like this is not an easy feat. They are usually able to move out around this time before the Lurkers are even ready. They should be able to push out on the map and take some map control, and then you've got to kind of kite them and try to cut off reinforcements and eventually try to surround and kill that Marine Medic force. But here, Soulkey's kept everything tucked in the base. TAENGU not able to move out at all. He's slowly starting to move forward, but we've already got Lurkers ready to go. So Soulkey is going to be able to transition this into a nice game here. Now, this is still a bit of a tricky situation that we've got with the base down in the bottom left. It's not easy to defend, but it is very far for TAENGU to walk in order to attack that bottom left. So there's a modicum of safety in that regard, and the fact that it's just going to be very hard for him to get over there. Now, Mutas are going to be forced to trail these Marines. He has 8 Lurkers on the way, so Mutas, they don't have a lot of heavy lifting to do here. They just need to buy a tiny bit of time so that these Lurkers can morph. And once the Lurkers are out here and underground in a good position, I think that he should be able to rotate around and start to hit the main, start to do some damage here, pick off a few of these SCVs building things, and just be an overall nuisance to what TAENGU is doing. Now, TAENGU, He's going to rotate over here towards the bottom left. It does take a lot of time to get down there, but he can come from an angle that probably Soulkey's not going to be expecting. He's putting out lurkers right at these choke points and getting ready for this attack to eventually come in. These vessels have made their way across the map. They're going to get a couple of good irradiates here, which is quite painful for Soulkey right now. He would love to stack up these lurkers and make sure that those irradiates can't go down, but he hasn't had time to do so thus far, it looks like. Here he's managed to get it done, but look at this. We're gonna come running in, try to kill off these lurkers. We got two. Oh, and a third lurker gonna go down. Wow, a great spread of marines able to get in here and deal a lot of damage. He's actually trying to run by over on this side. Oh man, that's a lot of marines that are gonna go down over here. TAENGU just kind of running in. He's actually probably panicking a little bit right now because he's just about able to break Soulkey here. He lost so much over on this side, though. That's 9 kills combined here for these lurkers. That's really painful stuff. Gonna pull the drones back onto the mineral patches. Soulkey going to stabilize here, but that was risky. That was a scary moment there for Soulkey. He almost lost control of his natural. That's not a good start here for our Zerg. He's gonna be going into what looks like Hygelisk Defiler play. We're right into Plague. We've got some Scourge out on the map, and I don't think there's any way to go, you know, directly into Ultra or something like that. So it's good that he's decided to go for this type of play. The CC got picked off over here at the third base, so he's not going to allow that to happen just yet. Mutas are still in high enough number to be a threat, although there are vessels out and on the field now. Two lurkers here. How many do we have at this location? None. No lurkers over here, and we're going to lose a defiler, it looks like. One defiler going to go down. The radiate comes out. Lurkers are going to pop through, so he does have the defenses prepared. But still a little bit scary here. But a few lurkers. Oh, can he get a vessel? Not quite able to get that. How many lurkers do we have? We've got 3, but it's going to be 1 here in a moment. There's a possibility that TAENGU could break through. Does he have fire bats on the way? No, he does not. Sometimes it's possible to just go for fire bats at a point like this. Nice pickup there on the vessel. To go fire bats and just shove through the dark storms when the Zerg player is low on lurkers, like this situation right here at the natural. If he had 4 or 5 fire bats right now, he could bust this easily, very, very easily. So unfortunately, he's not going for that tech play right now, not going for that fire bat play that we've seen so much recently. Lurkers and Ling's gonna start to move across the map. As Soulkey tries to take a fourth base, nice job picking off the vessels as they're coming forward. He's already gotten about 2 vessels here. Gonna lose the defiler in a moment, but that's okay. This defiler gonna be able to throw down another dark swarm, and he should have another couple of defilers in production. So that's kind of the rule of thumb, is when your defiler gets irradiated, you build another defiler immediately. And right before the Defiler dies, you cast a Dark Swarm. Your next Defiler will be out in time to chain the Dark Swarms together. That's kind of how it works. We've got more Defilers out here at the front. Ooh, Marines getting picked off here, slaughtered by the Lings and Mutas on that little catwalk bridge. TAENGU, what is his follow-up plan here? 5 racks and building tanks. We've got 1 tank out anyway. A little bit surprised to see the tanks coming forward here. There is already Dark Swarm, so they're really not very useful at this point. We get the Irradiate down here on the Defiler. Probably going to lose the Science Vessel, though. Yeah, that Science Vessel should end up going down. There it is. Does fall. More Defilers on the way here. Just going to start another Defiler. Probably at this base. I imagine so, but I can't tell for sure. Hydra Defiler making its way to the front. Now, we do not have range just yet, so we're still a little ways away from that power spike that we're looking for. However, Tengu hasn't really been able to get in and deal any damage here just yet. He needs to get in somewhere and do something pretty soon here. Otherwise, Soulkey is going to grow out of control in a moment. Coming in, getting a bunch of radiates down here is pretty nice. Getting some value out of those units. Gotta be careful not to send the vessels away from the marine medic, though. You might end up getting caught by some scourge. Looks like we do have firebats out finally. Thinking about using those to defend here. Oh, diving in. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What was this? He dived in on some lurkers here, it looks like. As the lurkers go down in the natural, he tries to dive in, but it's not going to work out too well for him. Being forced back once again, Tengu. Just about all the way to his third base, unfortunately. Needs more tanks up here, really, ASAP. Only three lurkers under this Dark Storm. He should be able to irradiate through all this. Maybe go for the Defiler might be a better choice, though. I think we're going to see a Plague come down here. That could be a really nice, juicy Plague right now. He's going to drop Dark Storm and try to run forward. Firebats are in high enough number, though. I think we can take this out. No, he doesn't have a D-Matrix or anything. He's not going to be able to do that. Coming forward, going to throw down Darkstorm right on top of this. Oh, a Plague on top of that instead. Gets the tank and quite a few of these Marines and Medics. Unfortunately, the tank does survive, though. We should be able to get some SCVs over there to keep that tank alive. Very important that the tank... The tank count continues to grow here. We can't be losing tanks right now. We need to keep them alive as much as is possible. Diving in towards the natural once again, we have some dropships that have just been loaded up, which could become a thorn in the side of Soulkey here shortly. Where are they going to head, though? There's coverage for overlords just about everywhere. It looks like the marine medic is going to end up getting taken out here. A vessel falls as well. He's going to take this opportunity to maybe try to run in here onto the fourth base, but no. Again, denied here. Soulkey has lurkers everywhere. Hydras everywhere. Drops are being loaded up here on the right-hand side. Will he be able to slip through? I don't think so. Do we have any Scourge around? Where are the Scourge? I don't see any. So maybe he can get in here and unload. However, that's a lot of Hydras, that's a lot of Lynx, plus the Defilers making their way over here. The drop, I don't know if it's going to work. Maybe he turn and drop here? No, he's going to still go for the main. Oh my gosh, that is so scary. Okay, he's going to turn now. He's going to turn now. Big plague on everything. Huge plague on everything. Big drop here behind the mineral patches. And he's going to turn and even drop over here as well. Oh gosh, these are going to die so quick. These are gonna die so quick. Okay, the mutas are not targeting them though. Okay, he does target them down at the end, but everything's been killed over here. Mutas get picked off as well. Tank count is starting to grow pretty significantly, but we don't have any, oh my god, we don't have anything mining over here too. Big mistake by Tengu, not mining in the top left. He's even on workers, but he can't bring that to bear right now. Trying to push in here towards his third. I think this is the only place that he really stands a chance of breaking through. But Marine's just going to walk over top of a bunch of lurkers right there. And the Hydras are in too high of number. They're going to completely wipe out these Marines. This is impressive to watch, man. Soulkey, just so damn good. This is something I've seen him do a lot recently as well. Triple hatchery in the main when he goes for the... a Hydra Defiler, Lurker style. He keeps just one hatchery down here. One hatchery in the natural. Grab this hatchery and triple hat in the main. Making himself very, very powerful. Three armor. About to be two attack here on these Hydras. Some Hydras making their way up here, but there are Marines. No medics with them though. And the bunker's not finished constructing. So I think that Tengu will be forced out of this game here shortly. This is getting really, really bad for him now. He's losing vessels still. He's trying to set up tanks in the middle of the map, and this is one way you can battle with this style of Zerg. It's by setting up a huge spread of tanks so that the Hydralis can't even approach you, and that's kind of a way that Terran players will occasionally win games, but We just don't have the factory count here, guys, unfortunately. No factories, really, to pump out all of these tanks that we need. We need, like, another 2 or 3 factories up here to just fill this area with tanks, but it's just not happening here for Taengu. Taengu is trying to get a good angle to fight these Hydras and Lurkers as they're coming down, but we're about to see Defilers make their way to the front here. We are seeing just a massive swarm of Zerg coming out from all of these hatcheries here as he takes another base and potentially even taking this base as well. Bunch of Irradiates coming down here, dealing with a few of these Lurkers, but there's the Defilers now. There's way too many Defilers for him to irradiate all. He has to, you know, pick and choose a few Defilers to try and irradiate here before the big attack comes. Here we go. This is all that Taengu's managed to muster. Just 4 tanks, 5 tanks here in the middle. I think that we'll see Soulkey break through this easily. However, we do have some reinforcements coming up their left-hand side. They're being blocked by that blinding cloud of a dark swarm here. Tanks will be wiped away. And, you know, that tank count that I was talking to you about for so much of this game has just been eliminated. We've only got 3-4 tanks left now. Finally adding on another factory. This is way too late, though. 21 minutes in. Soulkey is fully on the aggressive now with Dark Swarms landing on everything. There's really not too much Taengu can do at this point. He's 3-3 with these Marines, but the Dark Swarms are going to negate that completely, pushing everything back once again. Tanks here are going to be able to hold the ground for a little bit, but losing any of these tanks right now would be devastating. He cannot lose any more tanks here. He has to keep that number high so that these Lurkers and Hydras cannot just run up on top of everything. And looks like it's not going to be high enough. That tank number going to be reduced once again here. A big plague on all of these vessels, and a lot of them are getting shot down as Soulkey starts to right click on these low HP vessels. He's going to take more and more of the map. He's pushed himself all the way in here now. Looks like some medic marine. I'm not sure what they were doing over there on that left side, but Taengu trying to make some progress. Gonna get shut down immediately. Bunch of irradiates coming down here. Taengu desperately trying to clear this so that maybe, just maybe, he can hold this position and keep this mining going, but it looks like he'll be shoved away here in a moment. The Lurkers are underneath the Dark Swarm here, pushing ever forward, ever closer to the Terran natural and main base. And with more plagues going down all the time, it's so hard to keep up with everything that's happening on the map right now. Soulkey is just hammering units out endlessly here with his supply actually evening out to where the Terran supply is at this point. We've only got 4 Marines in a bunker over at the top left. That's not going to be enough to hold on against any sizable army that Soulkey can put together. He comes up here onto the high ground. He's going to turn and head up to that top left, and a lot of vessels are making their way up here while Taengu goes for this counterattack. Can he make something happen, though? No. He's going to back away and perhaps try to deal with these Lurkers over here. Bunker will fall. Lurkers are falling as well with the Irradiates coming down. They should be cleaned up, but the command center is falling here. Lurker will be cleaned. This base is up and operational once again. No base here in the center left. That's something to mention. But we don't really need gas that badly here as Soulkey. Just 2 gas is kind of okay right now. We're depleted now in the main and natural, but with 2 gases, this one and this one, rolling here, we've already finished all our upgrades. All the upgrades are done. We don't really need to worry too much about getting, you know, +3 or +... I guess we are going to get melee attacks now, but we've got the Defiler upgrades. We've got the Hydra upgrades. Those are all complete. We don't really have to... We don't really need that much gas to just keep pumping Defiler and Hydra. A few Lurkers mix in here and there. We might end up putting out less Lurkers. Maybe more Lings will be added into this composition here soon, but For now, it's absolutely fine to just keep building in those hydras. He's got plenty of money here. He's got this extra base for mining those minerals, and Taengu is really starting to run out now. He's only mining on this base alone, and that's even getting low. Only 500 minerals per patch on a lot of these, so he needs to find another avenue to take another base here. And Soulkey is just cutting off those directions. He's just blocking off this area and forcing Taengu to come out and keep irradiating him over and over again and opening up opportunities for an attack into something like this. There's not a whole lot of tanks here, but the tank number is growing. Oh boy, I'm afraid here for Taengu. He's gonna lose this position, I think. Dark Swarm comes down. There's not enough tanks up here. And this is at exactly the moment when Taengu was thinking about rotating his army. He rotated around this left-hand side. Set up a lot of tanks here on this low ground, but he's gonna end up losing all the SCVs up here, I think. He's gonna have to, like, transfer them over to a different base or something, because this is not going to maintain for much longer. Throwing down some Dark Swarms here, losing some more vessels. A lot of these have been irradiated, so he's very quickly losing a ton of vessels here. Oh, looks like he lost some more tanks over in this spot too. Getting in between the rallies and the attack is a good plan right now for Taengu, but I think that the writing is on the wall here. Taengu gonna turn and clear this up. Looks like he's just barely gonna pick off these lurkers here and probably stop the Hydras from killing his SCVs for now, but he's at 29 SCVs. So much damage has been done. There's a lot of tanks over here dealing a lot of damage to these Hydras, but unfortunately, I think a lot of them are going to get picked off. Wow, he does keep all of these ones alive. So he's got five tanks on this high ground, which is not bad. We do need more, though. A lot of Hydras coming here, but it's not much lurker anymore. There's really not many lurkers here to work with at this point. A big play goes down on everything. The Lynx are going to be soaking up a lot of this tank fire, and the tanks are going to hold things back for now. A CC has landed, and we can start to mine off of this base, thankfully, but at the same time, Hydra's making their way over here to the fourth base. This is a desperate situation here now for Taengu. Another vessel gets picked off. D-Matrix on that Marine. He's trying to fight best he can versus pure Hydra. It should be a pretty decent trade, but the high ground is helping out a lot here, even adding on some irradiates to the mix to try and help these Marines fight against the Hydras. But Hydras are still trading reasonably well, and all the SCVs here were killed once again, down to just 19 SCVs against the full 47 of Soulkey. The writing is on the wall here, but Taengu desperately holding on here. Can he stop this next attack? He will get an irradiate down on this Defiler, but the Dark Swarm will come in and force everything back once again. One more Dark Swarm just barely in range of these tanks, unfortunately, going to be forcing Taengu back here. He does need an irradiate or something on that. Just don't allow that lurker to get any more damage here. Looks like he might be picking off some SCVs, trying to repair this the best that he can, trying to hold this position in desperation mode right now. Oh god, Marine's gonna come forward here. They do get plagued and a Dark Swarm on top of them. The hatchery here, can he focus it down? And if he focuses it down and loses all of his Marines, will he be able to hold on to the counterattack that's gonna be coming forward here for Soulkey? Bunch of irradiates going down, but I don't know if they were on the same unit or what. It looks like he only managed to get two units with those three irradiates, so definitely one of them was on two lurkers there. And there goes the remainder of Taengu's army. He's got almost nothing left. Another Marine Medic Force coming up here. Pull the tanks back to high ground. Put everything together here, Taengu. We need to hold this next attack or we are just going to be dead. Looks like he doesn't have the Marines over here in time. The lurkers are going to run up. The Hydra is going to get under this Dark Swarm, pick off all the tanks. And with the tanks falling and the CC lifting, I think this is just about it. Taengu is going to be knocked out of this game. He's trying to push forward for one last desperate attempt, but a Dark Swarm comes down. Always Soulkey with the Dark Swarm control, able to clean up everything, able to take these good trades. So impressive, so difficult to do. It's really a testament to the skill of Soulkey he's got that ability with the Defiler control to just take fights like this over and over and over again and always have what he needs right when he needs it in order to hold on and push the envelope against a Terran player who's building a lot of tanks. It's not easy, but Soulkey makes it happen. Very, very well done by him. Really impressed with the amount of macro coming out. This is the Soulkey we know and love, is the macro legend here, just piling out units into the front line, never missing a beat, always keeping his money very, very low, and just spending and spending and overwhelming his opponent. Super, super well done here. TAENGU, we expected him to lose, but he put up a really good fight this game. He did hang on for quite a long time. He did some moves that I liked, but I think that he was a little slow on the Firebat transition. Now, there were some moments here where he almost managed to get into the natural. He almost managed to break this position. There were moments when there was just one lurker here. Just one lurker with Darkstorm on top of it. You know, there's a few more lurkers over here, which could have come through the Nidus. But if you've got like four or five Firebats at that moment, you stim and run under, kill the lurker, and send the Marines through to try and kill the Nidus, things can spiral out of control so, so fast for Soulkey, but, or for any Zerg player, really. But here, Soulkey was able to hold on with the bare minimum for so long. He was able to get his fourth base up pretty uncontested. He manages to, you know, keep those Defiler spells rolling over and over and over again, and he takes down a TAENGU here. Was a fantastic game, guys. I'm looking forward to playing some more of this style myself. It is something that I really struggle with. I think a lot of Zerg players struggle with this style as well, with the Hydralisk Defiler Lurker style. It's totally different way to play than, you know, getting into Ultra and Crackling and that kind of thing. It's just very technical, very control based. The Defiler spells are so meaningful. You have to continuously pump Defilers over and over again, and you have to keep picking off vessels with Hydras, which is pretty tough sometimes. You have to get the plagues on the vessels, and you have to gun down the vessels with the Hydras. Otherwise, you're just never going to be able to make any headway. It's really, really tough. And guys, thank you for watching here. We've got plenty more games coming up in the future. If you like this one, make sure to hit the like button, and I'll see you tomorrow.